I'm out here in these streets. I'm back with another video too. It's been a long ass minute, man. I'm actually working right now doing the door knocking shit. A lot of y'all don't know, I've been taking a break from YouTube to do this shit, man, getting it locked in, getting locked down. I actually have a pretty cool video planned for today though. I got some gear back home. The brand, the company sent me some stuff, some loot from my spoils of war and victory. They got me some shit that I'm gonna unbox for y'all back at the crib. But I'm outside right now in the sunset, and so I just figured I'd just kind of start the video here. It's real nice to just be back on the camera speaking to y'all. I'm a new me, dog. I had to take a step back so I could really, like, I could really get myself right type shit. Because if I was just uploading all the time and doing YouTube every day, it was just kind of too many things to juggle and then do this job at the same time. So I just needed to, like, take a step back, finalize this, you know, right here. Like, yeah, nigga, look at me. Look at me, nigga. I'm levels up. Very much so. Bank account jumping, life jumping. Nigga just got back from Vegas, went to Texas for the holidays and shit. I'll kind of go into that more in the video. Just kind of telling y'all where I've been, what I've been doing. But thanks for tapping in with the video today, man. I'll see y'all at home when I'm done working in this bread. Wop up. Hey, this setup kind of clean. Shit, bro, the room looking tough right here. No cap. I kind of feel like bad that I didn't start the video right here. You know what? Maybe I did start the video right here. What's good, guys? Maybe that next part's just in the middle, kind of explaining all that sunrise stuff. You got to get to the good stuff. Basically, today we're unboxing Sunrun gear. I got this from the Spoils of War. Every time I closed a deal, they gave me one of these products. You know what I'm saying? This one gonna be nice, cause sometimes it be bright as hell. I ain't gonna cap, it be brighter than a bitch, and you gotta get the hat going. Dude, I remember I did my first unboxing when I hit a couple brands up doing some photography, you know, like brand deal stuff, and it's funny to see how far I've come. Like, shit, boy, this shit crazy. This is a Veterans Day hat, I think. That's cool. I don't really be wearing hats and stuff like that cause my hair, but maybe when I braid it up, you know, that'd be something I want. I be thinking about, what if I go out in the do-rag sometimes? What if I just put the dewey on for the one time? This is just a shirt. I'm cool with the shirt. Hey, you gotta have one for the one time sometimes, just a chill one. Might be a cold day, but I'm liking this right here. It's black, it's a black button up. I'm gonna try some of them on. Get the quick jump cut or something. Ooh, okay. That's funny, I like this one. This is a clean one. Pretty basic, but you know, sometimes I like to just look clean when I'm out in the streets, you know what I'm saying? Dude, let me tell y'all about my last 2 weeks though. I'm blowing through this goddamn unboxing right now. This is a pretty cool one. I got a jacket. Hey, let's see how much the jacket costs. So I just came back from vacation. My vacation started, hold on. I can't even get to the vacation. You're gonna have to wait till after this, then we're gonna get to the vacation talking about that. Damn. I got one of them ones. Hey, sponsor. Come on. Hey, this video I ain't even really telling nobody that I was gonna post this one, so. If you tapped in with this video, you a real one, bro. Yo! Tell me, come on, bro. I'm gonna be out in these streets comfy. Bro, this is tough! Okay! Yes, sir. That's what we like to see. Dude, that's actually so dope of them. This is a nice jacket, like. Because sometimes I be repping the same jacket every day to work, no cap. Because, like, this is a pretty nice jacket right here. You saw me in the video this morning with the jacket, man. That's sunny. I'm kind of all over the place, man. I just got back from vacation, like I said. And I'm tired, bro, because, like, vacationing, when you gone in Texas so long, bro, it does something to your head. Like, when you are in Dago, like, it's just life out here is so nice. You go to Texas, it just be a lot sometimes, you know what I'm saying? But I'm just making this video for y'all, so I don't really care. I don't even care. But I'm lit though, this shit live as fuck. I got another shirt. Bro, this shirt alone, like $50. So 50, This is a $60 shirt, actually. It says 58. $60 shirt there. It's a $100 jacket. So we got 105, 60, for like another 50. I don't know what the tag is on that one. 105, 150.
Hey, Juicy, is that you?
250. Let's just say, no tag on it. Let's just say 25 to 275. Shoot. No tag on this one. Let's just say 25, just on the low end, because we don't got to highball it. That's like 300 right there. Like, that's crazy. $300 worth of Nike gear. I ain't even count the hat. Oh my God, I got another hat over there too. We up like shit, boy. Yeah. Hey, sun run. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. I think it's funny, gang. She wasn't always like this. She wasn't always like this at all. But, you know, it's here like this right now. If you still watching, bro, you the fucking GOAT. Oh my gosh. Sometimes I can't even imagine other people would want to like look in and like listen to my life. But for some reason, I don't want to post because I don't want people all in my business while I'm doing this stuff. Like, while I'm doing this shit. Life been pretty crazy for me lately, man. I won't lie. It's been very positive. I've been working very hard. And shit ain't been easy, but it's been amazing. shit ain't been easy. But it's been amazing, I ain't gonna lie. Let me take y'all around my apartment real quick, just cause I think that's nice to do. Kinda show y'all my Christmas tree, cause that's something I'm proud of, me and my girlfriend. Let me show you real quick, gang. Yeah. Come on now. Come on now. You see your boy? It's a whole Christmas vibe, you know, it's a thing. I feel goofy with this hat on, but I'm so happy. I'm proud of it, you know what I'm saying? The room a mess now. Man, I done started this video for y'all, right? And now I'm recording, I'm getting lit, I'm excited, I'm all happy. I'm like, damn, this shit, I'm excited to tell y'all this story. I'll just basically just throw up some videos up right here on the side of me while I'm talking, just kind of explaining like what I'm talking about. But last part of the video, I'm basically just gonna explain like my last 2 weeks, 3 weeks of life, just cause, you know, it's pretty cool. It's pretty, I like to have it documented somewhere. So basically, I just got back home from vacation, like I said, for the millionth time now. And my vacation started on a little bit, like 2 days before Christmas Eve. I went to Vegas with my shorty. There's a couple pictures right here. We went to Meow Wolf. It's like this weird marketplace where everything's trippy and like, views geek. Everything's super trippy in the market, and then like, go inside the market deeper, and then there's like these cave rooms and trippy psychedelic visuals, and it's an experience, man. It is amazing. Honestly, nothing like I've seen even in San Diego. And like, San Diego got some pretty high production shit, but like, and I've been to some places, but that is a whole nother level. Like, Vegas got that shit going. And we saw the Bellagio, a whole bunch of other stuff. My girl documented it pretty well, so this is all her videos if it's up right here. I was just geeked having a good time, man. It was like, Vegas is a tough place to be, but it's nice to look at. Like, the people in Vegas are shiesty for sure. Like, everybody got that look on them. They are like, fuck, like they angry about life and whatnot. And hate to see a young nigga succeeding in life and shit, but ain't nothing to do with me. I'm in and I'm out, you know what I'm saying? So literally did like so much shit in one day, man. Like so much shit in one day. And then we dipped out. We literally drove there, drove back out. Drove to Vegas, drove to San Diego. Flight, had a layover in Vegas, then flew to Austin. So we're in Austin, Texas now. I stopped by my grandma's for New Year's Eve. We flew in on New Year's Eve. I stopped by my grandma's house. Well, I had the whole family, brought Shorty over. It was really nice, honestly, just chilling with the fam, sipping on some grown folk drink for the one time. Just relate to everything that was different, because, like, I don't know, it's just good to be home, man. And then, so after that, we drove from, because, you know, we was in Texas, but we on San Diego time. So, like, after the grandma's place, we drove back to Piper's crib, and her crib, like, an hour away. So we drove back to her crib. Shout out Shorty, for mom's whip. Drove to her crib. Her parents woke up at, got her family woke up at goddamn 7:30 to have Christmas, bruh. I ain't never seen some shit like that. It was crazy. So we woke up at 7 in the morning for some Christmas. After it's like already 1 in the morning, we got home. And then it was a really good Christmas. Shout out to her family. They make a nigga feel real loved, man. Life is good. Life is good. Amen. Amen. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm having a good time making this video with y'all, so if you watching, I appreciate it. Don't need no love. I ain't gonna lie, because I don't even care what the results are. I'm up regardless, my boy, no cap. I like talking to y'all. Y'all my niggas, bro. Like, I don't even got no niggas. I don't hang out with no niggas, bro. I literally just work and mess with my girlfriend. But y'all my niggas for real, because if y'all give a fuck about me, that's crazy, because I don't give a fuck about nothing, nobody else, bro. I just be working, cuz. But I appreciate y'all once again. So let's fast forward. Let's get past the Christmas. So after Christmas, I'm chilling. I see my homies. You know, we go downtown. You know, just having a good time. Doing some awesome things, nothing crazy. I got my wisdom teeth cooking out. And it's the only picture I got of myself after my wisdom teeth. I don't even remember taking it. It's just so funny. I had Kanye face for so long, and my face still hurt. It had the boy on codeine. Had him have me like a zombie, bro. I wasn't messing with it. But yeah, probably gonna have to take my last one tonight. But I think I'll be good to go after that. Let's see. So then I went to... So after Christmas passed, a couple of days passed after my wisdom teeth removal, I got to see my nigga Jalen. Shout out Jalen. Shout out Augie too. Them my boys, for real. I don't got many niggas, like I said, but them my dogs. After that, we went to motherfucking Port Aransas, Port A. I ain't never been to Port A, but shout out Shorty's mom and dad and Shorty, because today brought me to Port A, because that was a hella nice time. We went to this aquarium. Saw some sharks, saw some hella cool shit. It was nice just to be at the B&B, me and Shorty, you know what I'm saying? Just chilling, having a good time with the fam. My dude, I gotta stop and say this. Bro, her mama gave me a Christmas present and a birthday present. My family went on a cruise for my birthday, and I'm not on the cruise on my birthday, my nigga. Hey, I just turned 20 though, so we up. And I was in Port A with my girl. Like, hey, life is good. So I was in Austin, went to the Gulf of Texas, went back to Austin, got on a plane, flew back to Dago, went to sleep, woke up, did some workout, went to my journal, went out, got a haircut, knocked some doors. It's all right here. Like, I'm just throwing it up as I'm getting through it. Knocked some doors, and then got home. Took forever to make food, but I got some leftovers, so it was worth the adventure. And now I'm making this video for y'all. I really didn't want to, like, at this point, I got everything I wanted to say out. Like, as far as I wanted to get on this video, so I'm pretty happy about that. If you want to just continue chilling with your boy, you can, because I got some more shit to say. Shit, man, I'm just thankful that you're still watching. But let me stop real quick, and we gonna re-up. So if you gotta, you know, you gotta hit the pen, you gotta get some snacks, nigga, just go do that. I'm gonna continue the story. Honestly, this video is straight for the homies, straight for the guys. Whoever just really rocks with me, just because I appreciate y'all as subscribers to, you know, still be tapped in with me and just want to be knowing what I'm on and shit. So I feel like y'all deserve the transparency, because I appreciate what a nigga let me know what's up, to let me know like where he been and what he doing. So I figure I can share that information with y'all, just because y'all the homies and y'all deserve that. So I'll take y'all about So I'll just take it off from the start. I quit that. I didn't quit. I got fired from that security job. God is good. I started working with Sunrun. This is the largest solar provider. I'm out here door knocking. And so I've been working this thing called the 60-day combine. It's basically where you have to get eight. Dude, this is so funny. It's weird talking to a camera. It's been a minute, really. But you had to get 8 welcome calls, which is basically like you got to close 8 deals within 60 days, business days or whatever. And I did 9, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm pretty proud of that shit because it was hard as fuck. Like, if you ever like been door knocking or, you know, even tried to sell your own business, like entrepreneur, I've been an entrepreneur my whole life. But door knocking as a salesman, as a, you know, a solar rep is completely different ball game, man. It's been like some really eye-opening experiences, and I've grown a lot and learned how to communicate my ideas better with people a lot easier. Right now I'm chilling at the crib, I ain't even gonna lie. Probably a little bit geeked up, you know how it is, my guy. But I just had to get this camera out because, you know, you just deserve the transparency. You deserve to know what's up with your boy. Like, shit wore me up as fuck, though. Like, it was not easy, but we made it through. And so that's what I've been doing the last, like, I don't know, like 90 days or whatever. Like, I've been gone for a minute. I just been handling this shit. None of that big money hit just yet, but I got some big good incentive money on me, and they just sent me all this gear. I got the deals. Look up how much a solar representative would get for a solar deal, and I that shit's crazy. So that's the kind of opportunity that I've been like having on my shoulders, having on my hands right now. And YouTube is very important to me because I got a feeling in my heart that I'm a leader for these people who. For the people, like, for my younger self, you know what I'm saying? I'm leading everybody who want to get out the trap, want to get out the suburbs, because, you know, I was a young black kid in the suburbs, and I was thinking, like, I don't want to sell drugs. I don't want to, football is not, like, you know what I'm saying? I was really like that with the football, but, you know, I got injuries and shit. This college was not making sense, and I was like, I still got to get rich somehow, and, I've never seen an opportunity like this to get rich, and I think that this is a great way to get to do so. So that's what I've been doing. If you're seeing this, you're a funny guy. I appreciate you for watching, but this is just a blooper take. I'm just out here trying to get back into the swing of things and shit. And man, I appreciate you watching the video, because damn, I ain't made a long one, and I ain't made a video in a minute. In fact, you sat through this whole video and watched to the end, because I imagine it might be a long one just because I got a lot of stuff to just say and just kind of just blab up, because I don't know how long it'll be before I make some more videos again. But when I do come back, man, there are going to be movies. Like, they're going to be game changer. They're going to be like what I really want to make from my heart. You know what I'm saying? But the opportunity that I have right now is just so big and grand to me that I just gotta handle this shit first. So I'm gonna handle this shit, and I'm gonna be back to y'all real soon. But be on the lookout for content, because I might just feel differently about it when I got this shit a little bit, you know, locked in a little bit more. I definitely got it locked in, but you know how it is, dog. I'm the perfectionist sometimes, I can't lie.